Everyone, Extreme speaking. First of all, go do your own due diligence on everything I bring you. And remember, never invest anything you can't afford to lose. Since I'm just a mere YouTuber sharing my experiences. Yes, I know it's Thursday, and only on Fridays I do my recommendations and issues. But I'm going off the grid for a few days. So, I'm bringing you my recommendations and issues a little bit earlier than normal. My first recommendation today is Qubit Tech. The more I look into this company, the more I'm impressed. The more I want to see. I've deposited already, and I'm going to do another deposit. Why? First of all, they're transparent. I haven't seen a company this transparent in a long time. They just keep on bringing you more and more. For example, look at their Telegram page. As you go up and look at it, it's you, real people. They're opening office after office. I read something, they already have 4 offices in Russia. They have offices in Bangkok. They have offices all around. And their returns are decent. I've seen from 0.4 to over 1%. And they said they can give up to 2% return daily. As you can see, seminars teaching the people how the program works. For me, that's a good indication. We're seeing who's buying the company. They have communication, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Telegram. They're even on TradingView. Now, every trader out there will know exactly what that means. They're having a meeting in Dubai. You get invited to go. It's robots trading. Get them for free or you can pay for them. They trade until you get 250% back on your money, meaning you're getting 150% profit. I've asked them about the debit card. It's still coming. It's in progress. A company that's working for you, bringing their own card. Another tick, another thing that's good. Here's the team behind everything. Greg Lionel, the founder and CEO, and it just keeps on going. Arijit, I've seen him doing Zoom calls. I'm impressed with this company, and for sure, I'm going to add a little bit more. So this is my first recommendation today. It's Qubit Tech. They look similar like MTI, which is a good thing. MTI just keeps on going. I'm impressed with these guys and I like what I'm seeing. I just want to see, I found something else I want to share. They're showing their licenses. Yardic Telegram page showing their analysis. Here we go. Is this what I was looking for? They even have a roadmap. Not many companies give their roadmap what they want to achieve. I'll say look into them. It's a good company from the eye, from the view. What's going to happen? How they're going to do everything? Time will tell. But for me, they're worth taking a chance on. But remember, go do your own due diligence about Qubit Tech. My second recommendation is Bitex Network. Their exchange launched. I've mailed them and asked for an interview with them. And they did reply and say, yes, I can have the interview. So now I'm waiting to hear when the interview is going to be. And this is just another good thing. They have a YouTube channel. Communicating, and as an exchange, the big question is, will they be able to take on Binance? If they are, it's going to be a massive one, but only time will tell. it's profitable or not. Battalion, the one that just keeps on going. It's more or reaching around the 3 months mark now, and I'm still getting my payments and they're still moving forward. If my calculations is correct, it's around 6% weekly I'm getting from them. And you need to withdraw your money. It can't stay on a platform. So every Monday, if you have more than $10, you can withdraw with ease. FXD Center. The disappointment. I got 2 pending withdrawals. And some people still can't log in. It seems like they didn't even reach the launch day of 15 September. Too bad, but I've moved them into my losers group. Fruit Times Capital. Their chat is still going on, the Discord is still there. There's talks that they'll be back around the 29th of August. Will they be? We don't know. But that's what I've read in the Discord. What can we say? Only time will tell. And the big one in the news at the moment. Mirror Trading International. A lot of news coming out, and they've released their own press statement. They went on their own to the South African National Board and were denied. They're applying for a Forex license to keep on trading Forex, but on the 21st of August, they're moving to crypto trading, which is an unregulated scene, so they don't need the license for that. They're saying when they get the Forex license, they'll be back trading crypto and Forex. What's this going to mean for the company? What's this going to mean for our profits? Well, time will tell. That's what I have for recommendations and issues. Remember, do your own due diligence and make sure not to invest anything you can't afford to lose, since the platform can be here today and it can be gone tomorrow. Have a great one.